Could neutrons be hydrogen atoms? First thoughts and revised thoughts. First thoughts. The mass of a neutron and a hydrogen atom are the same. Hydrogen atom is 1.008 amu, atomic mass units, and neutron is 1.008 amu. Proton is 1.007, and the little electron is 0.0005. The hydrogen atom is made of a proton and an electron. My suggestion is that a neutron is made of a proton and an electron too. Beta to K is where a neutron transforms into a proton, electron, and antineutrino. Electron captures when an electron pulled into a nucleus combines with a proton to make a neutron plus a neutrino. Hydrogen plasma is hydrogen where the protons and electrons are separated. My next suggestion is that in a nucleus, every proton from helium on is paired with at least one neutron. This may be because protons that have charge are more separated in the nucleus by the neutrons so that they won't repel each other. The neutron has no charge. Note some atoms have extra neutrons. There may also be some force that pairs each neutron to a proton in the nucleus, making a more stable form. Deuterium, an isotope of hydrogen, has one neutron paired with one proton in its nucleus. Deuterium forms stronger chemical bonds than hydrogen. Now, substitute the words deuterium nucleus for any neutron paired with a proton, and you discover that all elements have earmarks of deuterium nucleus in every neutron and proton pair. Further, where there are two such neutron-proton pairs, there are earmarks of a helium nucleus with its two neutrons and two protons in its nucleus. Finally, those elements with two such neutron-proton pairs, like that found in a helium nucleus, are notable. The most common elements in the universe often have this configuration. Helium, two neutron-proton pairs, carbon, six pairs, oxygen, eight pairs, neon, 10, magnesium, 12, silicon, 14. Now, the revised thoughts. The comments I've received about my premise asking if a neutron and a hydrogen atom could be the same have suggested some needed adjustments. Both the neutron and hydrogen atom have the same atomic mass units. Both are in my model made up of one proton and one electron, but there are differences between the two. For example, when it comes to stability, a free neutron decays after 10 to 15 minutes into a proton, electron, and antineutrino, but a hydrogen atom does not. Though in extreme heat of hydrogen plasma, the proton electrons are separated. This and other reasons suggest some fundamental difference between a neutron and a hydrogen atom. So what is it? The proton is the same in both, so I rule that out. That leaves the only thing left, the electron. My suggestion then is that while a hydrogen atom has a single electron in a shell outside the nucleus, the neutron has that electron within. That means the neutron, unlike the hydrogen atom, is a proton plus electron condensed together in a single composite. That resolves many concerns that I've gotten. The drawing shows my model for the nucleus of these elements, helium and carbon. NH stands for neutron hydrogen. P stands for proton, E stands for electron. Note how the neutral charged neutrons keep the protons apart. Yet at the same time, each neutron pairs with a proton. Summary. If this is true, we see an atom in a new way. The neutron that was seen as a sidekick in the nucleus now becomes the star and center stage as a different form of a hydrogen atom. Paired neutrons and protons are added to the nucleus to get the rest of the elements. Somehow, every neutron is loosely paired to one proton. Then, too, we see that every nucleus after hydrogen itself has at least one neutron paired with every proton or a deuterium-like configuration inside the nucleus. Next, we see that some of the most common elements have two or more paired neutrons and protons or a helium-like configuration inside the nucleus. The neutron may be the key to the nucleus.